Hi everyone. In this tutorial, I just want to talk a bit about fashion or clothing design or characters. These are just some examples of some of the stuff I think we can be heading towards. And I'll just talk about the process of, how to come up with clothing, how do you come up with fashion. And it's not character design exactly, but it is kind of a vital part of character design. And anyway, let's draw. So one of the first things that I think is kind of important in character design is, or in clothing design, is who are you putting the clothing on? So whenever I design clothing, I always design from the inside out. So that means that I don't draw clothing right away, even though the end goal is to draw clothing. We have to figure out, who is this clothing fitting upon? So I always go with a very, very, I always start with the figure. And another thing about clothing design, even though I was doing a lot of, interesting poses and whatnot, when I do my initial sketches, I always have just a very, very simple figure. And the reason why is because, again, we're only designing clothing. We're not trying to worry about things like poses and all that other, annoying stuff. It's not important at this stage. And plus, whenever you start dealing with, different perspectives, you start dealing with, three-quarter angle perspectives and all that stuff, it impedes you. It gets in the way, because then you're worrying both about how to draw something in perspective in addition to, drawing and designing clothing. So, and then also whenever you're designing clothing, if you have like really weird camera angles and it's all dynamic and interesting, the other problem is that even though the pose itself is dynamic and interesting, you won't be able to depict the clothing, in a way that is clear and easy for others to understand, especially if you're working, in a production environment and other people are taking your designs and having to understand them. So, don't get all fancy with the pose. I know that we all study figure drawing and art, and we're always encouraged to do, crazy and dynamic poses. But right now, this is just design of clothing, and we're not drawing individual comic panels. And you don't want to confuse. You don't want to get confused. You don't. You need to focus, okay? Because I'll tell you this much: is that like doing clothing design is troublesome. It is tricky. It will require every single, every single atom of your concentration. And so, make your job easier for yourself. Just go for a simple straight on pose. Later you can draw different angles, but for your initial sketch, just keep it simple, because we just don't want to run into troubles later on, and we want to have a nice and easy way, a nice and easy time of designing our clothing. So I'm just, making a very, very rudimentary, rough figure drawing. I am trying to keep it relatively symmetrical. And of course, you don't have to draw, the same figure that I am drawing, because, again, I said that clothing is something that you design from the inside out. And so if you are, you're not always going to be designing for the female form. You may be designing for big fat guys and midgets and even creatures, like aliens and whatnot. And so every figure is going to require different clothing, because clothing in the real world is tailored to, the person that the clothing must fit on. So I think I've got a bit of a lean to the side, so I'm just trying to correct that right now. And I'm actually spending a fair amount of time on the figure, even though it's really, it's like, yeah, I'm figure drawing, even though this is a clothing tutorial. I'm trying to get something that is relatively symmetrical. I suppose I could have just, drawn half the figure and then done a mirror flip, but I don't know. I don't draw too well when I have to draw about, when I only see half the figure. So anyway, I'm just drawing a very simple figure. And actually, I shouldn't even worry about the line work, because I'm doing this, as an outline. Because the next thing I will do, the next step is to do this as a shape. So I'm using, just to avoid the inevitable question, what program I'm using. I'm using a program called TVP Animation Pro, or TV Paint, as it's also known. You can find it on www.tvpaint.com. And it is a 2D bitmap-based animation program. As you can see, I can draw with pressure sensing, and you know, I can get right into the pixels. And you know, it is not a vector-based program like Flash is. So, you know, Flash has its own uses and whatnot, but in this case, I like my bitmap-based stuff because I can add as much detail as I want, and it doesn't, you know, it doesn't get slower and slower, and then eventually I'm sitting there pushing and pulling Bezier points. This is why I like the bitmap-based stuff. So the next step, as you can see, I'm working on a neutral gray background. And one of the reasons for that is because with neutral gray backgrounds, they're not like white backgrounds where you get really blinded. If you look at photographs, you'll notice that very few photographs, unless it's a high-key photograph, you know, high-key photography will have white backgrounds, but most photographs you see have very little white in them, like pure white. Pure white only exists whenever you have bright camera flashes, bright lights. If the camera is actually pointing at a light, only the actual light source itself will be, you know, white. If you have that light that is reflected, those are the only parts that are white, but everything else is not. You know, everything else is going to be a different shade. You know, if the film is properly exposed, and or the picture is properly exposed, then that's what you get. You know, it's don't. Well, I won't say don't, but I say, you know, it will help you. It will make your job a lot easier if you work with, if you work up on neutral gray. So anyway, I'm looking at this and thinking, let me just toggle that off. I'm thinking that maybe I should move my character just up a little bit. I've got all that headroom right now. So what I'll do is I'll just bring up the transform tool. Oh, that's not the transform. This is the transform tool. I'll just pan that up a little bit. Maybe I'll even shrink it down because I want to have little room on the top and bottom. The other thing about working on a gray background is that when it comes time to choose colors, it becomes also a lot easier. I don't have to worry. Like, I find it's a lot easier to judge colors. You can, or at least judge values. It's like, if values have the ability of, you know, if values that you choose, you know, lights and bright, lights and darks and whatnot, if they can go on a scale between, you know, white and dark, you know, and like between black and white, white and black are the extremes of your value scale. And, you know, when you paint some, whenever you draw, you know, you don't draw starting at the top left corner of your canvas. You don't start your drawing on the bottom right corner of your canvas either. You don't, you know, start drawing on an edge. Well, I guess you might, but I wouldn't recommend it because you only have one way to go. You know, you can only go to the left, or you can only go to the right, and that's troublesome. And the same thing can be said for values. You know, whenever you're working with paints and you're working with values, you know, you don't want to start at an extreme. You don't want to start at pure white because you can't go any higher than white. You don't want to start at pure black because, you know, you can't go any further down than pure black. So starting at a relatively, you know, dim neutral gray gives you that latitude both ways, you know, for your colors. And, you know, then you get more options. You get many more options, and it becomes easier to judge your colors, you know. So center not only your drawing, but center your colors as well, or center your values. And I'm just working with this shape cutting tool. So in TVP Animation Pro, there is a tool that I'm using. It is known as the freehand shape. So all it works, it's like a lasso tool. I can just, you know, I can basically cut it any shape like that, and it winds up like that. Programs like Alchemy and Flash do also have similar tools. So if you're drawing along, then, you know, by all means, you can use Alchemy or you can use Flash. I am seeing some asymmetry in my drawing, so I'm going to fix that up now. I can tell that one arm is fatter than the other. So unless I'm making a charger for Left 4 Dead 2, I had better fix that up. Sorry, I'm just trimming one arm down, and you know I could just use the mirror tool again, but I don't want to. All right, so I've got my figure. I can turn off my line layer, and this is what remains. So the next step is a tool. There's an option that you can turn on in Photoshop and in TVP Animation Pro, which allows you to preserve transparency. And what this does is, as I use the shape tool, it doesn't, you know, basically I'm working on a layer. And if I just show you the checkerboard right now, you see this is what I'm working on. I'm working on this layer here. And my background color is set to this neutral gray. So anyway, I can now start thinking about things like skin color. You know, now we can start deciding whether or not, you know, she is of, you know, Caucasian descent or Asian descent. If you want to have, you know, goth girls, you know, or albinos, then you can do that. You know, if you're having your aliens, creatures, or whatever, you know, it comes down to a skin color. And again, I'm seeing some asymmetry, so I'm going to just fix that up. But sometimes you will see, you know, as soon as you see a problem, fix it up, because this is sort of the understructure that goes under everything else. And if you don't solve it like right now, it will come back to haunt you later, and then it will kill you in your sleep, along with all of your family members. And then there will be a curse on your family for 7 generations. So solve your initial problems at the basic level, you know, as soon as you can, as soon as you detect them. If you have gone ahead and you've done some work and you realize that you screwed up somewhere in the basic level, then you had best undo and go back and just, you know, do it right before, you know, plodding onward. Some people, they just want to press forward and they just want to, you know, draw. But then what happens is the drawing gets harder and harder over time because it's built on an increasingly shaky foundation. So as you can see, the silhouette is really, you know, giving us a lot in terms of, you know, it really does give us an idea of, you know, the type of body. You know, it's really, you know, the body type. It really is showing up here. And I'm maybe spending a little bit too much time, you know, on trimming things, but you know, you want your figures to be, you know, somewhat appealing. And so, you know, I feel it's a worthy investment of time to make a good figure. Because, you know, try as you might, you cannot dress up Rosie O'Donnell. You know, it doesn't matter what kind of clothing you put on Rosie O'Donnell. She will still not be. I'm sorry. I'm just predisposed to thin people, but it won't. You know, it just. Yeah, it won't be attractive. Okay. So anyway, now that I feel a little bit more confident about this character, I'm just gonna, you know, let's choose a, you know, more or less generic flesh tone. And then the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create another layer. And in TVP Animation Pro, I'm going to set the that clothing layer, not the clothing, but the body layer. This is my figure layer. I should start renaming my layers. Hang on. Figure, and then I should rename this one to on undergarments. Okay. So anyway, I'll just show you my layers. I've only got three layers. There's basically, here we are. I've got my figure, I've got the undergarments layer, and then on top I have my line layer, which is turned off. It's hidden anyways. So let me just turn all three layers back on and throw my layer window back up there.